Today we are talking about week numbers in Power BI calendar table. Now, calendar table is clearly one of the most important tables in Power BI. Almost a table which every model should have. And having a week number in there allows you to report your metrics, your numbers, your sales in this case, week by week, as you see that here, and as you see this in this graph on the green line. That's my weekly sales. So you can see this is Sunday, May 22nd and Sunday, May 29th. Now, of course, you can choose a different start of your week. I'm choosing a Sunday here, but it can also allow you to do things like a rolling average over the past 10 weeks. So this is kind of week by week and it fluctuates, but a rolling average is smooth. Smooths that number out. So let's get started. My name is Avi. I'm a Microsoft MVP and a best-selling Power BI author. And if you would like to become a Power BI Pro, then make sure to subscribe and ring that bell, my friend. That's important so you are notified whenever new videos go live. And I go live every Friday to answer your Power BI questions. Now, as I said, calendar table is one of the most important tables in Power BI, and I have discussed this extensively on my channel. So if you head over to my channel, and we can actually link it in this video as well, but if you are on my channel, then look under the playlist section, and that's where you're gonna find the good stuff, including the ultimate calendar table right there. And that has all the details about how to build the calendar table. You can download the table for yourself and just use that by copy pasting it in your own model. Now, what we're focusing on today is the week number, and our task today is something that was sent by Marjo Bisson. Okay, I probably butchered her French name, but Marjo asks that, Avi, your calendar table does have the week sequence number already built in, and it's pretty awesome. It lets me do things like this, rolling averages, as I showed you. It also lets you do even more advanced stuff, where let's say you only want to show numbers for the last 5 weeks and have it automatically update as time goes on. You can do all of that already. But what she's looking for is there a way that I can make the week sequence number restart each year? So that's the task, that's the quest that we're on for today. So again, we have this, so what she's talking about is the way the week sequence number is set up is it starts with the first week at the beginning of your calendar table, and my calendar table starts in 2014, January 2014. And it goes up from there. So the next Sunday we get 2 and so forth. But if you go to 2015, then it starts at 53. And if you go to 2016, it starts at 105. So she wants a version of this which restarts every year. Now again, there is a reason why this one is sequentially increasing, because only then can you easily do things like rolling average. You can do like past 5 weeks and so on. But again, let's see if we can help Marjo with her task of restarting week sequence number each year. Now, I will give you kind of 3 answers to this. The first answer is, if you're really truly interested in week numbers, and if you want to do it the right way, then my friend, you owe it to yourself to explore the 454 retail or merchandising calendar. Just Google that and you'll find something like this. And what this does is it makes sure that week boundaries are consistent. So you can see that every year, every week is always a full week. There are no partial weeks in this calendar. And that means that you're always comparing apples to apples. So again, if you're really truly serious about, you know, kind of weekly and making sure you're comparing apples to apples, then this is the way to go. But assuming that you're not into that stuff, then you're using a regular calendar table, then let's see how we can make this work in week sequence num. Now, my first idea was this. So I'm going to show you 2 approaches in this regular calendar table, and you can pick which one you like more. The first approach is that I'm going to go to my calendar table, and I would have my date, and essentially ignore the existing week sequence number that I have in my model. So I'll ignore that. That has already been built in. And again, you can see this is the ultimate calendar table. Again, watch the rest of the videos that I pointed to get more details on that. But for now, we'll just go to this date column, and I'm gonna say, I wanna add a column which is based on this date, and I would like to get the day of year, right? So again, I just kinda went in there and said day of year, and I'm expecting something like 1 to 365. So we'll say day of year, And if I look over to the side, perfect. So day of year, kind of one. And if I scroll down, I expect it goes to 365 and then resets, which it does, right? So you can see 365 and then resets. So that's exactly what I want. And then I'm gonna add another column. So we're gonna say add column based on that. And we'll say divide by 7. All right, so you can see I'm trying to do the weeks here. Now, of course, this gives me a decimal, and what I need to do is just round this number up, round it up. Let's go find that. So this time, I don't want to add a column, so I'm going to switch to transform. I want to operate on this column itself, and transform looks similar, so I'm going to look under the number thing, and let's see, rounding, that seems promising, and you can see round up is right there, so I'm going to select round up, and now let's see, so we have a series of ones, series of twos, looks good. Let's go back into our table, let's give it a good name, first of all, not division, let's say weeknum, and I'll say based on day of year. Now, of course, if this was a real model, I wouldn't call it that. I'm just giving it a descriptive name so we can keep things straight in this video. All right, so let's go back here, and I'm gonna go grab that new column that we just created, week number based on year, and I'm gonna switch to 2014. So 2014, it starts off at 1, but remember, our goal was that it should reset every year. And I'm gonna turn the totals off because totals don't really make sense in this table right now, right? So it starts off at 1, goes up at 2, and so forth. Let's see if it does reset. 2015, boom, it starts off at 1 again, 2016, and again, you can see that kind of goes off 1 from 1 to 52 or 53 in case there was a partial week there. However, once I used this approach, I wasn't a huge fan because the way that this is working is in 2014, the week one is just the first 7 days, so it goes from Wednesday to Tuesday, and if you look at 2015, it just goes from Thursday to Wednesday, week one. So it's somewhat arbitrary, and I didn't like this approach. So what I wanted to do, so I'm going to show you the second approach, where I'm going to go back to my original week sequence num, use that because it's Sunday based. So I like that, and of course you can change that if you want your week to start on a Monday. That's easy to change in the calendar table, but I wanted to stick with that Sunday definition, but all I want is it not to keep going. I want it to reset. So let's think about this, and I always say that human learning comes before machine learning. So how would a human do it? Well, if I were to do it, I'll just figure out, like in 2015, if I'm looking at all of these dates, right, all I have to do is figure out the smallest number. The smallest number here is 53, and just subtract 52 from everything. So that means that this becomes 1, and if I subtract 52, this becomes 2, and this becomes 3, and so forth. That's it. So that's human learning, and now let's teach Power BI the exact same steps. So we're going to go back to our query and calendar table, and I'm going to add a marker, which I forgot to do initially. I'm just going to insert a dummy step and just call it, saying that, hey, we're working on something here. So we'll grab this thing and let's call it new week number, something like that, right? So again, I like leaving those markers, especially in complex query, and you can see this one has quite a few steps. So now let's add another one of the steps here, and I'll rename it again. You know, let me make this window smaller so that's not off in a corner over there. So here I'm going to rename it, and I'll say weeknum approach 2. Okay, cool. So weeknum approach 2, we're good there. So remember, our goal was to figure out the minimum week sequence number for each year and then use that to subtract it, right? So for that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my query, and I'm going to use a group by. So I'm going to say group by year. So for every year, I want to figure out the minimum of the week sequence number that we already have, and I'll say max minimum week sequence num. like a week sequence number, week number, right? So I hit okay, and there we go. And I have that exact number. Now remember, so if you go back to 2015, I would like to subtract not 53, but 52 from each one. So I'm gonna take this and then transform this, and I'm just gonna subtract one from this to get the actual number that we wanna use. So perfect, so now we get 52. So that's the number that if we subtracted 52 from each of these numbers, then we would get the number that we are expecting. So now let's use this and merge it back to our original calendar table. So what we're trying to do is this is our result right now in this row, and we're trying to merge it back to our original calendar table, which is sitting over here. Now I'll show you the way I do it. So what I do is I go in here and home, and I'll say merge queries, and I'll merge it to itself. So I'll say calendar, current table, itself, and I'll merge it on here and hit OK. And it generates this M syntax for me. I'm kind of lazy about M. I'd rather it generate for me. And so it did the merge, but the thing is that I wanted to merge this step, subtracted from column, from weak num approach. And you can see in the syntax, all I have to do is change that up here. So I'm gonna grab the name of this step and go back to my merge and say, no, don't merge subtracted column this step with this step itself, merge it with the previous step, and here it's its name. That's it, simple as that. And now our merge is done. So what we did was we ended up merging our original calendar with the minimum week sequence number. So now let's go back and continue over here. So now I have my calendar table, but on the side I also have the minimum week sequence number. I'm going to grab that value and I'm going to create a new column, and let's call it week num, and this is based on week sequence num being reset. Let's just call it that. So week num, new week num based on this, and we're going to take our original week sequence num and just subtract this number that we just calculated in the query editor itself. That's it, and we can throw away this column. This is not needed anymore, so we'll remove this one. That was just like a working column, and I love doing this part in the query editor. And let's see how it looks in action. Woo-hoo. So this was our original week sequence num. Let's go back to 2014, and we're gonna bring in the new one, which is supposed to reset. Now, of course, right now we're looking at 2014, so that's where my calendar starts. But this is a real test. If we switch to 2015, does it continue on or does it reset? Let's switch to 2015, and boom, you can see that it resets because, again, hey, we built this whole thing, right? We calculated the 52 number, and all it's going is it's subtracting that 52. Now, of course, it not just works for this year, but it works for every other year. And again, it's using that original week sequence number that we had, but now it resets it. So Marja, hopefully that helped you. My friends, hopefully you like that approach. Hopefully you learned something new. Again, calendar table is one of the most important tables there can be in your model. So go ahead on my channel and grab the Ultimate Calendar download. Watch all the videos. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. Make sure to subscribe and hit that like button. Until next time, power on, my friend. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.